The word worship is combined with two words. You're combining two words together. One is ship, and ship has to do with water and the high seas. And so ship, we have a ship on the end of so many words, like companionship or dealership or scholarship, all kinds of ships. You know, and it has to do with water. But then you take the word worth, W-O-R-T-H, worth, meaning the value of something. What is it worth to you? Well, certain things might be worth, you know, a tremendous amount to me. A picture of my mother, my dead mother or something, might be very valuable to me. But to you, it's just an old picture. You know, so it depends on your individual placing of a value on something, how it's, what is it worth to you? And so when you take the word worth and put it with ship, like dealership and friendship and scholarship and all the other ship, you put it together, because worth-ship, which you drop it and just say worship. No, it's worth-ship, meaning whatever it is you put a high value on, we say it's what you worth-ship. And so if you put a high value on money and nothing else, well, then you worship money. If you put a high value on property or your jet plane, well, that's what you worth-ship. And so you need to understand what the word worship means. It means whatever it is you put a value on. And most people don't realize that whatever it is you put a value on, that's where your heart is. And if you put a value on something, and then one day when you get to be older, you find out what you believe and what has been the object of your worth-ship, now it becomes obvious that it was not true. Now you have to look at your life. You've spent all of your life believing something, and then when you get to a certain age, it finally occurs to you and it finally hits you that what you believed is not true. And you've spent your whole life teaching other people, preaching it to other people, and now you find out you didn't know what you were talking about. That's why I say that your mind is like a parachute. It don't work if it's not open. So that's what I'm trying to do, is help my fellow man to realize how much we don't know.
Well, and I'll tell you what, worship in and of itself is a key. And why is that? I've been scolded, to be honest with you, proclaiming that somebody worships something. but what they're doing is exactly what you described here, which is placing in a high worth upon. And,
that's right.
You know, if you're worshiping something that at the end of the day doesn't really hold its value, there are people who I can confidently state worship money. They just do. I mean, that's what their life is about, right? And there are people who worship experience. I'm not so sure what to say about that, because, you know, trying to gather experiences and things like that, in some ways, you know, people do it in a healthy way and people do it in an unhealthy way. And quite honestly, that those that worship just being able to collect the experience, to me, I don't know. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, Jordan. I leave that to the individual's ideas, right? But when you see people worshiping, you know, worldly goods, as if they are the mark by which all things should be judged. You know, somebody's rich, so therefore they're a smart person and they're a good person. You hear that kind of thing said and you say to yourself, it's almost as if they're worshiping the money, because that money allows so much value to be put on this individual that they become something other than a man or a woman.
That's
they
right.
become above the others because they've collected something. And what does that really mean? And then there are others who say, you know, what is it you worship? They ask the question, what do you worship? And they ask that question to me a lot, because I really don't give a clear definition of what my spiritual beliefs are on this show in a lot of cases. I think I do, but apparently I don't. But when I say, you know, life in and of itself is a mysterious creation, and to me, to worship it, to value it, is really the thing that should be driving us. That we should value life in and of itself and not make these decisions that there are lives that are not worth something and there are lives that are worth something. I mean, we're now separating people into piles, right?
That's
right. Some people are pennies, I guess, and other people are silver dollars.
That's right.
According to some people, to go back to the money, because it's one of those things everybody seems to recognize and never bothers to question. Really, throughout most of their lives, is that money exists and therefore does this. They question that less than they do God, certainly, any time. Okay?
Yeah, of course.
But it's interesting.